very good. Yeah. See, and.
I've been waiting for a moment to wear this.
Tonight was the night.
We bought it today, and you know they don't come in men's sizes.
Yes, they do. They're available at any decent store in men's sizes.
Now, have you got, obviously you're a fan of the One Direction, I can see, but has One Direction met Ian McKellen? Is Ian McKellen One Direction before?
I thought he'd have a bigger beard.
Yeah. But didn't you come close to meeting in New Zealand?
We were on tour in New Zealand, and they were filming.
Yes.
And you were meant to come and see us filming
the day
after your final concert. So I thought I'd go and have a look at them, see who they are. Yeah. Very enjoyable, thank you.
Thank you.
It was
he's a wizard, so I think he wins.
It was a very small show. I mean, it was just you, no fireworks or anything, but quite a small theatre. Do you remember?
Cinema. Back in the day.
Yeah. Anyway, they didn't turn up the next day to visit us because why? I don't know. Why? What had happened on your last night?
We're on the water tonight, though, we're safe.
Yeah. Your plane might have been moved early or something. Now, Ian McKellen, because I saw the pictures of you all at the premiere on Monday night.
Oh, yes.
And, I mean, it's been part of your life for nigh on 14 years now. So, was that an emotional night, or had the emotions happened already?
Yeah, well, it's over. You know, we've not been working on The Hobbit for some time now, but it was very moving. I mean, you go, and these kids have been sleeping out all night. Well, you know about this, but the
We're all homeless.
These people were not born when we started making Lord of the Rings, you know. So it's a big part of their lives, and that's very, very sweet, isn't it? And they'll be able to see all six movies now and show them to their kids. And that's what's nice. We've made classics. That's lovely.
And also, it will take nearly a day to watch it.
But it can be done.
Have you done it?
Yeah, I think I did it. I was off school ill once. I think I did it with my friend. I think we watched them.
Hmm. But all
I mean, we might have watched one or two.
Or three or... Da, da, da.
You're amazing.
Right answer.
So are you.
I like that. Niall down the end just clapping. Yay!
I don't know why Niall and I are kept apart like that.
I don't know.
You kind of look a little bit alike, actually.
Hey, listen, One Direction, huge congratulations. The new album, your fourth album. Now, these statistics are crazy. 85 countries this album has topped the charts. Is that, I mean...
No one's told us this. This always happens.
No, really?
Yeah, no
I can never believe... I imagine someone would just be waking you up to kind of go, we're number one, 85.
No, we did find out we were number one in the UK and in America, but we haven't had a recent stat list, an update.
Well, there's 83 unimportant countries that have also enjoyed it enormously. And also, much excitement and congratulations, 3 American Music Awards.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Because over there, do they think of you as British, or are you just like a big pop act?
I think they think of us as British, don't they?
I think an Irish.
An Irish, obviously.
Of course, yes. Sorry, no. Wow, there would have been letters. I can't believe Graham Norton said. And you know, it must have been a thrilling night. Lovely, they won so many prizes.
I don't know.
And yet, there must have been a little anger afterwards, where they felt a bit upstaged by Zayn's hair. Now, that was Zayn's hair on the night. Now, had you planned the loose strand?
No, it kind of just fell that way.
Just fell that
way? Yeah.
I mean, it looks lovely, okay? It looks lovely.
I think it works.
But it Twitter sphere meltdown about this hair. Here's just a selection of some of the tweets that they... Zayn's single strand of hair is prettier than my entire face! We haven't seen the person. It could be true. It's another one. Zayn's hair is the reason for my tears. What's next? Oh, I love this. Zayn's hair tonight is why I still believe in miracles. And then This is genius. Someone was just so moved, all they could treat was this. I want to strangle myself! Die on his shoulder. This album, I think there's only two songs you're not credited as writers on. So, of the five of you, who does the most writing?
I think it's like a toss-up.
On this record in particular, I'd say you two did the majority of it, didn't you?
Yeah,
we kind of go away in little teams and just go and write with people, but...
It's kind of awkward to nominate yourself, isn't it?
Me!
Is it like The Apprentice? Don't volunteer for anything. Keep your head down, you'll be fine. Yeah, I'm still on the album. Yeah, I didn't do a thing. Yeah, I'm fine. Because lyrically, I don't know about you, and I think they've always been impressive, lyrically. Mm-hmm. But often it's hard to make out the words with the music. So I wondered, Ian, if you could help us out.
What am I going to do?
You're just going to read out the lyrics so we can fully appreciate them. And
In Gandalf's voice.
Oh, no.
So let's take us to a special reading place. Here we go.
Yeah.
Special reading. Love. Oh, nice.
Nice.
Now then.
And we danced all night to the best song ever. We knew every line. And now I can't remember how it goes. But I know that I won't forget her, because we danced. All night. To the best song ever. I think it went, I think it went, yeah. I think it goes, you don't know you're beautiful.
Was good. Well, you'll love Ian McKellen in The Hobbit, The Battle of the Five Armies, which opens next Friday, the 12th of December. Now, we saw the clip there, and I mean, some movies, the title can be misleading. You know, there's people aren't blown away by wind. But in this, it really is. But it really is The Battle of the Five Armies. Yeah. I mean, it's huge.
Yes. Well, I've seen the movie, so I agree with you, but I never saw these armies. It was just me and the mates just pretending to fight. But I don't know where they all come from. They're all in a computer, aren't they? But they don't look it. It's amazing.
No.
Absolutely amazing.
But some of them must be real.
Well, the ones close, yes, I suppose they are. The ones who are actually fighting, yes. But don't ask me any more about that. I don't really understand. The best thing about seeing the movie is I now understand the plot. I mean, I had no idea what that was. Oh dear, well. I don't know where we are in this show either.
But because, you know, you've been in the X-Men franchise and now Lord of the Rings and The Hobbit. Yeah. So both of those films, legions of fans. When you're walking down the street and you see someone kind of go, oh, I know him, can you immediately spot whether they're X-Men
Yeah, if they're an adult, it'll be the X-Men. And if it's a child, it'll be the Middle-Earth films, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
But adults must go see Middle-Earth films.
Yeah, but maybe they didn't particularly enjoy them, I don't know. But
someone got to a lot of them.
It's the little kids who want to meet Gandalf, or Gandalf's representative, rather like they want to go and meet Santa Claus in the shop, you know, at Christmas time. They know that I'm not Gandalf.
Old men.
No. Yes. Old men. Yeah. But thank God people like old men, huh? Yeah. Don't they?
There's a word for that. And the fans, when they meet you, do they all want you to do kind of the Gandalf? Catchphrase is the wrong word, but.
Well, I've been going around schools recently, encouraging people to.
I'm gonna stop you there.
Yes, I know.
He was invited!
And I go around encouraging kids to be nice to each other and not to bully each other. That's a good thing to do.
Yeah.
Particularly not to bully the gay kids in school, or indeed the gay members of staff. So I was... Is this leading on to a little clip?
Love this clip.
So I was with the head teacher and some of the senior students, but outside the head teacher's window, there was a crowd of really small kids who wanted to have a look. So I pulled up the blind and had a chat with them.
So this is, where is it, near Bristol somewhere? And it went viral, kind of. Viral, man. Went all over the place. This is Ian at the school.
In your preparation for your examinations, if you don't do your revision properly, do you know what will happen? You shall not pass!
I love that. That's so sweet. Do people now try to make you do that all the time?
Yeah.
Okay, boys. You're going to do your current single, Night Changes. So the stage be over there. Up. Oof. There they go. Yeah. Good boys. Good boys. Good one direction.
Very good. There they go.
Surely we'll have this week's stories in the big red chair. But first, performing Night Changes. Then jump. But it is One Direction.
Blowing out tonight changes into something red. Her mother doesn't like that kind of dress. Everything she never had, she's showing off. Driving too fast, moon is breaking through her hair. She's setting for something that she won't forget. Having no regrets is all that she really wants. Just reminds her of the missing piece of innocence she loved.
But there's nothing to be afraid of. Great job on your hoodie leg. Well done. A beautiful job. Lovely sin. Well done. Sitting down. Okay. Here we go. Oh. How gorgeous is that? And what a treat. Thank you very much. And actually, we should say, very exciting, One Direction, you've just announced a UK and Ireland tour.
Yeah.
It starts next year on the 24th of September at the O2.
Tickets are available tomorrow at 9 o'clock. They go on sale.
Could you save a couple for us? We'd love to go.
Yes, we live locally, don't we?
We do, yeah.
We live there.
And they didn't come to my pub after what?
Well, it doesn't matter.
Freddie, you're not going. That's not happening. Hey, listen, before we go, let's have a quick look at this week's red chair. Who's up there? Hello.
Hey.
Hi.
How you doing?
I'm very well. What's your name, sir?
My name's George.
George, and you're from Canada, America?
Wimbledon.
Who knew? Okay, George. And do you have a job, George?
I do have I'm an animator.
An animator? All right. Off you go with the story.
I was on holiday to Antarctica on a small ship, and a little ways in, things started to not go so well and didn't feel like my normal self, you know, seasickness kicking in. Long story short,
good.
Couldn't hold it down. It came up right into my hand, and I just... knee-jerk reaction, slurped it right back up.
That was gross, that one.
I thought you were saying get it down.
I'm saying get it down.
Oh, I thought you were like, get it down, you're lovely. Oh, yeah. Don't waste that. Oh, yeah. Who's up next?
Are they actually there, these people?
Yeah.
It's green screen.
You are so not used like to this. I love this. Ian doesn't trust anything now. Are they really there? I think I'm at One Direction. It might be. I don't know. Look like them. Who do we have? Hello, sir.
Hello.
It's Ronan Keaton.
Ronan, how are you?
How are you, Ronan?
What's your name, sir?
I'm Sam.
Sam. And what do you do, Sam?
I'm a comic book editor.
Ooh. Ooh.
Animators and comic book editors.
Do you know the animator?
Oh, I wish.
What is going on back there? You just joined a line. You were like, oh, now I'm in a chair. What's this? All right, Sam. I assumed lumberjack, but no. Go with this story, Sam.
So a couple of years ago, I'm helping out in an orphanage in Romania.
Can I just stop you there? Now we can't laugh. It's such a lovely thing to do. There we go.
No, you can. I need a bit of a break, so I take the kid's dog for a walk. So I take the shortcut across a farm in between us and the house. All over the farm courtyard, there's what looks like dried hay. So I'm walking along with the dog, and then the dog just disappears. I'm thinking, where's the dog? 2 seconds later, I'm up to my elbows in a cesspit. I managed to get the dog out, but I can't get out myself. I'm slipping around, obviously covered in sewage.
Yes.
So basically, I'm in there for probably about 5 minutes, and then when the farmer realizes I'm not playing around in the cesspit, he did actually help me out. But I got covered in shit. So.
No good ending, these stories. I'm quitting. Well done, everyone in the red chair. Very good. If you'd like to join us on the show and have a go with that red chair, you can contact us via our website at this very address. This is it for tonight. Please say thank you to One Direction. Join me next week with music from Nicole Scherzinger, comic actress Tamsin Gregg, hot Brit actor Jude Law, and Hollywood star Jim Carrey. Smokin'! I'll see you then. Good night, everybody.